before we move on.
All right, Dad. Woo!
Hello, hello. Okay, so first of all, I want to thank everybody for coming. It's so help us celebrate this joyous, wonderful occasion for making time. Thank you all. So when I look at Veronica and Nick, I just think, wow. I said earlier they look like the power couple, but it's kind of like what a beautiful pair. And anyway, they look like those are two people that are getting ready to go somewhere special. And it reminds me of a slogan. I was doing a job out at Boeing Leadership Center, and they had this slogan on there. It said, "The sky is no limit." And I thought, wow, you know, that's probably close to yes. Anyway, so we're so very proud of you both. Nick, by the way, graduated magna cum laude from SLU and is heading off to fighter pilot school. And we'd like to thank Nick and his fellow schoolmates that are dedicating their lives to service for our country. So I want to say that. Make sure everyone's proud. Woo! So, Veronica, she worked her way through school and landed her dream job with a little help from some good friends. And anyways, she's all set up for success. You both accomplished a lot before you got married, and you have more to accomplish now that you are married. So, King Solomon, he was a pretty wise man. He said that he knew the benefit of someone that had your back. He said that, you know, though one may be overcome, two can defend themselves. And three is even better, meaning that with the Holy Spirit with them, that they can be stronger. So God knows that I would be lost without Liz, and she would probably agree because she called me Mr. Go all the time. I have trouble with directions. So anyway. My point is that Nick, never leave your wingman alone. You need to stick with her, because life can be a tough fight, and you'll be stronger with her. So the last thing I need to say is Nick, now that you're taking my princess to your kingdom, I thought I would tell you a little bit of my father-in-law, Big Charlie. So, Big Charlie, anybody who knew him, he loved to eat. And everything that we did revolved around a lunch, a dinner, a snack, whatever it was. And we always had to go to places. So, one of those times, he would introduce me as his son. And I'm like, well, I'm not really his son. I'm his son-in-law. And he did this several times, and I was kind of embarrassed, and it's pretty special, you know, that he called me his son. God bless.
And now we give our next speech, our father of the groom, Steve.
All right here, Steve.
I'm scared of mics. I'm not prepared with a crap for this. Make a nice speech. Craig is going to pay for this. I told him when he was in the womb, Air Force or college? Well, you kill them both. So So that's a huge accomplishment. He's going places nobody else in the family's gone. He's going to go higher. The Air Force will get high. So I'm choking. I'm proud of him. He's got a good girl. So I guess I agreed to this last night. I didn't realize it was an actual agreement. I met Nikolai here through Mr. Steve when we both worked at Boeing. He introduced us, and Nick became a roommate. Young buck, there, single young lad. We were having a great time. We were. And Ronnie came around. She was really great. We had great views out of our windows. You know what I'm saying? On that third window, looking down. Yeah, and it was an amazing time. And as a mathematician, you know, I really look at the statistics, and you know, and it's like, oh man, you know, yeah, this is like 50 open. It's over 50%. Ronnie kept hanging around. It was like month. And I got to know her a little more. And at some point, you got to realize who your friends are. Huh? If we all look at Nick, we know there's no chance he's going to do better than that. You know? You know, lock it down before it gets away. So, congratulations, guys. I'm super happy for you. So I'll keep it quick. I know everybody's probably a little bit hungry here. Been here for a while, cocktail hour, naps and all that. But good evening. Thank you all for coming in such short notice, and especially with the surrounding circumstances today. We're super happy to have everybody here the way it is. It's just fantastic. I can speak for Ronnie that as well. But Mom, Dad, Eric, and anybody else for that matter, about 10 years ago, have you ever seen me get married?
No. Not even home.
What about five? Yeah, see?
No.
Okay, neither did I about 3.5 years ago, which is when I met Ronnie. But that's pretty much going to say that I've met some wonderful friends and mentors throughout my life, that many of them are in this room today. Throwing back some beers, just saw that. Nice. Thank you for being here. And they pretty much molded me and taught me how to be myself and be a better person, a better man. And all that goes to say, I know I'm not here for motivational speech and all that nonsense, but okay, I'll get to the point. So basically what I'm trying to say is that it takes a lot to land a woman like Veronica here, and a whole lot more to keep her, so I'm going to tell you that.
You agree?
anyways, where's it going? I'm just trying to stall it. Yeah, but anyways, that's a challenge. It's a challenge to look forward to for the rest of this thing we call life. So, grab your glasses, throw them up to Veronica.
To Roninator.
Me too. Okay, all right.
And a Nick. To Ryan Nick Morris.
Thank you.